The inspiration for this project comes from Harvey Pekar of American Splendor fame and his challenge to others to tell their own story of splendor. Well, okay, it was not the only inspiration. There was this beautiful woman who for the time of this creative moment was my muse. I had the desire simply to write something, anything that would get her to notice me. And I was living on an island in the San Juans at the time. This is my story of island splendor. I mean, here I am, right? A janitor cleaning a movie theater, 7 days a week. It is late night, everyone has gone home. Seats are empty now. And I am left to sweep up what has been discarded, forgotten, or just plain left behind. I find all kinds of loose change and unopened candy, articles of clothing, mostly hats worn by teenagers. It's not like one is going to find anything really important. Though once in a janitor's lifetime, I guess it does happen. I remember finding a $10,000 watch. Must have been close to that. All diamonds and such. I didn't keep it, of course. I'm an honest guy. And I guess I wasn't the one who found it, but I was the one who returned it. This husband and wife came asking about it. Well, the wife did. Beautiful blonde, but not in that typical blonde way. Certainly not vacuous. Her husband looked like one of those car salesmen who made it big and now just came to the island to show off his boat. He had on what I like to say was his true face. A scrowl. Anyway, he seemed more interested in punishing her for having misplaced the watch than being glad of its return. She was not happy at all. And when she looked at him to say, "Aren't you going to say thank you or reward this fellow for returning it?" he just scrowled. I like scrowl. Not sure if it's a word really, but something between a scowl and a growl is the look he was giving. He again just scrowled. She was so embarrassed. And as they moved on down the street from the theater window, I saw her glance back at me with this ashamed and forlorn look on her face. I thought to myself in that moment that maybe the watch is not what she had really lost. Maybe it was something else, something more important. I guess I am not really that good at finding things after all. I mean the really important things. If I could have found that for the lady instead of the watch, then I would have felt a lot better, I think. Finding the important things isn't like finding the spare change in the movie theater, I thought to myself. Maybe the important things have to find you. But that is the great tragedy of being a janitor of a movie theater. Then when you most want someone to find you and pick you up, all of them have gone, and all the seats are empty. And just the popcorn bags, spilt cups of soda, and half-eaten candy bars remain.
Pizza. Pizza asshole. I am. Nobody really likes me. They just like me.